before we talk about the playoffs and stuff like that, let's talk about these coaches and stuff like that. Urban Meyer is now the head coach of the Jags. Robert Saleh, y'all remember him? He's that hype defensive coordinator for the 49ers. Well, now he's the head coach of the Jets. Dan Quinn, new defensive coordinator, Dallas Cowboys. Eric Bieniemy could be going somewhere. He could be going to Philadelphia. I forgot who the Lions hired. I think they hired somebody. I forgot his name. They hired somebody. And yeah, there should be some front office changes and stuff like that. You know, the other guys we don't know and don't care about. You know, the rich guys, the billionaires, the billionaire owners and GMs and stuff like that we don't care about. That are probably getting hired and refired and whatnot. But here we go. Playoffs. Divisional round. And it is going to be one heck of a show. The top two seeds on both sides of the equation are hosting games this week. So, first up is the Rams. Number 6 seed taking on the Green Bay Packers. And the Rams, what the Rams have to do in this game is they got to make sure that, you know, Aaron Donald is completely healthy. I'm not sure if Cooper Kupp is healthy. But Jared Goff should be fine. I think Cam Akers, you know, they've been giving the ball to him a lot recently, you know, when he's been able to get it going. You know, Cam Akers can get it going. And everybody else, you know, has to step it up. You know, everybody else has to step it up for the Rams. Jalen Ramsey, he's going to have to defend, you know, Davante Adams on the other side of the field. And that's what I'm thinking that matchup will be. And if he can lock down, you know, Davante Adams like he did for the most part against DK Metcalf last week, I think, you know, things will be good for the Rams. Now, if Aaron Rodgers gets the ball out to other guys on the team, you know, like Aaron Jones and Robert Tonyan, you know, it's going to be a long day. You know, Aaron Rodgers is just playing a damn good season. He's basically going to be the MVP. And then there's, like, you know, there's all sorts of things going on right for the Packers. So the Rams just have to get – they have to keep the Packers off the field. They have to keep them off the field. And if they can't, it's going to be a long night. It's going to be a long night. Meanwhile, on Saturday night, it will be the Bills taking on the Ravens. Man, Lamar Jackson versus Josh Allen. One hell of a game. Let me tell you that. One hell of a game it's going to be. You know, you got the three-headed monster in the backfield for the Ravens, you know. And I wonder, you know, is Lamar going to throw it at all? Because, I mean, he threw the ball last week. He threw the ball. But, you know, I'd say, you know, the Ravens would have to expose the Bills on the ground even more. Like, I know Hollywood is there, and I know he's probably going to be going up against Tre'Davious White. But, you know, I think if the Ravens, you know, continue to outmaneuver the Bills on the ground and keep this game, you know, short, sweet, and simple, so keep it close, I think the Ravens will have a much more of a chance. Now, if it's a shootout, if the Bills, you know, make this a shootout or something like that, I don't know if the Ravens have enough firepower, you know. You know, the wide receivers for the Bills have been coming on in the last few weeks. Gabriel Davis, Isaiah McKenzie, and Stephon Diggs, you know. They have been coming out on fire the last few weeks. And, you know, if that happens again, you know, I don't know. Can Marcus Peters and Marlon Humphrey defend all that? I don't think so. Meanwhile, on Sunday, the defending Super Bowl champions, the Kansas City Chiefs, who, you know, boast all sorts of talent on both sides of the ball. And they're taking on those Cleveland Browns, the Brownies. And, well, it's going to be interesting to see how this game goes. You know, the whole Texas Tech connection, you know,
storyline.
And what that entails for both teams. And the Browns have to do the same thing they did last week against the Steelers. They have to get some pressure. They have to get turnovers against Kansas City. The only way Kansas City can lose is if Kansas City plays, you know, like absolute garbage. And Kansas City hasn't been playing very well lately, but they've been playing well enough to win games. But again, you know, there's talent all over that Kansas City offense. Kelce, I mean, Mecole Hardman, I mean, you know, Tyreek Hill. Come on, it's just talented. It's Sammy Watkins, it's talented. Just a talented, talented offense. Clyde Edwards-Helaire, who was injured, now he's back. You know, and Le'Veon Bell's even there, you know. Le'Veon Bell's even there now, remember? You know, he's done some stuff this year on offense. But on defense, you know, the Honey Badger is lurking back there. He is lurking back there along with Sorensen. He's lurking back there too. And if Baker Mayfield throws bad throws like he, you know, he sometimes does. I mean, he's only thrown one interception the past few weeks. He's only thrown just one. And I'm very surprised at that stat. Very surprised at that stat. But, you know, those two guys get back there and, they start to get Baker rattled. You know, Frank Clark up in the front. You know, if that defensive line starts to make Baker feel rattled, and those two guys in the back and the defensive backfield get at that ball and start getting interceptions, oh boy, it's gonna be a long night. I think the Browns did reactivate Denzel Ward. I'm not sure, but you know, it's up to the entire team on defense for the Browns to get some pressure on Patrick Mahomes to keep these wide receivers, you know, keep them contained. But it's going to be hard. It's going to be a hard task. You never know whether you have to try man or zone against, you know, guys like Tyreek Hill. You never know what you have to do, because Patrick Mahomes could just throw it downfield. Tyreek Hill would be right there to get it. So, last but not least, we have the Saints going up against the Bucks, round three, and this is the most important round. But the Saints have beaten up on the Bucks twice. They've beaten them up twice, and Drew Brees, he's looking to take himself, you know, back to the Super Bowl one last time, go off into the sunset with a W, you know, in the Super Bowl. But he's got to get past the Bucks first, and the Bucks have been playing very well, you know. They've been playing so well lately. I mean, you got AB, you got Cameron Brate, you got Gronk, you got Brady, you know, throwing it to these guys. You got Godwin, you got Mike Evans. I mean, he was, you know, Mike Evans was injured, you know, last two weeks, you know, but he was able to play anyway in the wild card. And these guys are getting it done at the right time. The offense for the Bucks is making it work at the right time. Now it's up to the Saints to stop the Bucks one last time. Can they do it? Can they? I mean, obviously, you know, it runs through Alvin Kamara for the Saints. You know, I think the Bucks defense, they've been on and off the past few weeks. You know, both teams have been, you know, on and off the past few weeks, you know, playing well and then playing like trash. But it's more so the Bucks that do this. Because, I mean, they'll have games where they dominate the Packers, but then, you know, lose twice to the Saints in an embarrassing fashion. And that can't happen again. You know, that can't happen a third time. You cannot lose to the Saints a third time if you want a Super Bowl for Tom Brady again. You can't have that happen, Bruce. You can't have that happen, Bruce Arians. Sean Payton will make sure of it, you know, if you don't play well. I think that's all for them. Yeah, that's all for playoff games, you know. But what do I think? What do I think? I don't think it will be, you know, 1-2 in both, you know, conference championships. I think that if the Rams could get it going, they do what they did last week against the Seahawks. I think they'll be able to advance. But if not, Packers will go to the conference championships and they'll host potentially either the Saints or the Bucks. And again, I think the Saints have to play well, and so do the Bucks. So whichever team plays well, they'll play Green Bay. As far as the AFC side goes, I think it could be Chiefs Bills. I mean, I'm not even gonna be like that. You know, I think the Browns can keep it close, but I think the Chiefs will just have too much firepower. We'll see. You know, we'll see if I'm wrong or not. But you know, I'm thinking Bills. But if Baltimore pulls it off and makes it close, then Baltimore will go to Kansas City in the AFC Championship. So, yeah, that's all I got to say. Coaching stuff, you know, playoffs and, you know, things of that nature. And what I'm thinking is just like, wow, we're getting close to the end of the season. Man, it's crazy. But, yeah, that's going to do it, everybody. I'll see you guys on Saturday night to wrap up the first two playoff games.